We're going to start it off like this today, man. Shout out to Queens, man. Rest in peace to the late, great Prodigy, man. Mobb Deep. You feel what I'm saying? This right here is classic. Let's go. This is fucking classic.
Another day, another dollar, it's about getting money. Then you can give me a holler, my nose running. I've been out in the cold, hustling for so long. My hands numb, but bet I feel that paper hit my palm.
It's like, oh shit, it's on. Time to go shopping for cars, not fashion. I went be the bomb, my clothes be the same shit that we had on. Say that for the broad.
It's the H-A-B-O. Dump and reload. Knock, knock, answer that. I'm clapping through the peephole. Body charges paid, lawyers, so we be those. Get locked in, I'm slutting lady CEO.
We the only niggas you know that fuck they POs. They push our files to the top, you still on parole. We got money to roll, no time for penitentiaries. Too much dollars to fold, it's bulging out our jeans.
But losing ain't an option, girl. My destination is top of the world. Top of the world.
Here I go again. Here I go.
But losing ain't an option, girl. My destination is top of the world. Top of the world. Y'all like bitches. The chit chattering. Stay not liking the nigga. Be giving that to them. Have don't change for no chick. And they adapt to them. Never get cool with you niggas.
I mean, rest in peace to the late, great Prodigy, Mobb Deep. We gonna keep it going, man. We gonna go back to Brooklyn to who I considered probably top three most underrated rappers of all time. This came out in the 90s, and my man went in, Busta Rhymes, off the motherfucking, was it the When Disaster Strikes album. Know what I mean? This song right here. Woo! Y'all remember this, y'all. Y'all remember this. This is 98. This came out today.
Just get off my block.
The way Busta was spitting on this. Come on, son.
Lord have mercy.
Flip mode.
Flip mode trilogy.
Come on, Busta. Talk to him.
Hey, yo. We ain't familiar at all, nigga. Don't like it, go back your gap and let's brawl it at all, nigga.
Straight forward.
When we used to chill up on park benches. My 20 block radius think we need some barbed wire fences. Stop bitch niggas like you from easily trespassing. Nickel nine shine on your eye, then you see fire blasting. Get off my premises. Ain't no warning, is you a friend of this? Back to back to John and show this nigga just who the winner is. The presence of a small time of diminishing blemishes. I'ma play your ass out like a game on my little Sega Genesis. This is inappropriate. Fuck if we talking for, we ain't even associates. Ass lyrical beatings, straight trick or treating. Hey, what you eating? I ain't got no words for you, fuck speaking. Ain't part of my crew, face it too brand new. Who? Niggas ain't even allowed to send my pass through. I can't chill on my corner, can't go on with my bodega. Chill before I call Dinko to grab the Quattro Cinco. We don't give a fuck right now, we be the high caliber shit. Y'all corny niggas must bow, we do unforgivable shit. We blow the spot anyhow, move, ready for battle. Cause I'm refusing to lose, I'ma beat your ass in front of nobody with nothing to prove. Live nigga shit right here, beware, stand clear. None of y'all niggas is welcome here. Fuck is these niggas, son?
Get off my block.
Yeah, I don't know none of these niggas, dude.
Get off my block.
Them niggas wanna sell they weed here.
Get off my block.
Yo, who these unfamiliar cornholes?
Get off my block.
Let's run these niggas off my street corner. Get off my block.
Yeah. Oh, I feel good today, man. I feel good. It's been a good week. The week is starting out good, man. Spirits is up. Work is going good. Kids are going good. Shit, God damn it. Mike, come on, man. Don't do me like this. Yeah, man, but everything's going good, man. Let's get right into the show. Welcome back to episode 186 of the All Jokes Aside podcast. I'm your host, Wil Milz, a.k.a. King Dirtbag. Look at that, y'all. 14 shows away from the ever-elusive number 200. And I told you this a million times. I've technically been past 200 episodes. I have way more than 200 episodes. But however, we're going to keep it legit. Nothing that wasn't called 200. I mean, numbers, we didn't count them, but I got plenty of live shows. And you know, guys, I've separated those anyway. So when you guys see me out and about interviewing people with my media setup, that is All Jokes Aside Media and TV. All Jokes Aside TV and Media. All Jokes Aside TV and Media. If you guys want to book me for your event, holler at me. I'm going to start putting up my manager's information on there because I did hire a manager now. And also, once again, guys, we do have a producer for this show, for the All Jokes Aside podcast. That is my bro, Jason. I will formally introduce my manager once we get that paperwork out there. You know what I mean? He's doing his thing. He's going to help me manage my comedy career and, as well as manage the TV and media production side of things. But let's get right into the show, man. I hope all you're doing good. You're in good spirits. You're feeling good, feeling great. You know what I mean? Your summer's going good. Staying cool because it's a hot summer. As you guys know, I'm in Florida right now. And you know what I mean? It's August about to hit. And when August hit, that's when them hurricanes start making noise. And we've been ducking them. You know what I mean? But like I said, we about due. Now, I think we got fucked up last year. We caught one or two last year and knocked my power out. So I think this year, I don't know. We might be on record to get another one, but you know, keep our fingers crossed. I honestly be looking forward to it, to be honest. But you know, when you become a homeowner, your feelings about that become a little different. You know what I mean? When you got to board up windows and shit, make sure your family got water, generators, and all that. It ain't like being in an apartment where the maintenance take care of all that. You got to take care of your own shit when you're in the house. You got to board up your own windows, make sure your own family got power, stocking up on water and food. You know what I'm saying? You know, we fortunate to live in central Florida. I ain't by no beach, Miami and all that. I'm in the central area. So if anything, we get a lot of wind and rain, but we don't be getting flooding and all that, like Miami and Tampa and all that shit. We ain't got to deal with all that. Anyways, let me check out the doc and see what we're going to get right into first. We got quite a good, fun show to talk about. I want to talk about this. Who remembers recently on TikTok, it was a dude named Superstar Pride. Y'all probably remember him. Dude had the wild haircut. He had that song that was popping for a minute. Named Superstar Pride. Let me play him real quick. Y'all remember? This was the song that came out. And the nigga hair was crazy. This dude right here. That video sitting at 27 million views. Nigga hair is nuts. Nuts. Nigga look like Vegeta and shit. 2 a.m. The night still young. You live by the gun, you gon' die by the gun. Ain't no handouts for nobody. When I ain't had shit, they ain't offer me nothing. When I'm quiet, I be thinking about killings. A lot of nigga bitch may stay in they feelings. Saving these hoes, this here pitiful. All these little bit of bitch my chillings. Whew. And mama, don't worry, you raised a gangster. I'm a survivor. It hurt me not being able to give you what you want since I was a top. Alright, first enough of that. First of all, anybody who walk out the house with their hair like that as a maniac. That's not even the Texas shag. That's some other shit, right? Now, he got famous, because first of all, that song go in. But it's a part in the song where the nigga said, when I'm quiet, I be thinking about killings. I believed him. Listen, look at him when he said it. Look at him. Look how he moving, holding the mic. This is a street nigga. Look at him. I want y'all to look at him. His. First of all, the hair's crazy. But his. Look at his body language. Ain't no handouts for nobody. When they ain't had shit, they ain't offer me nothing. When I'm quiet, I be thinking about killings. A lot of nigga bitch may stay in they feelings. Saving these hoes, this shit here pitiful. All these little bit of bitch my chittens. Alright, so yeah, I think the nigga was about to like. Well, anyway, recently he was arrested for first degree murder. It's not funny, y'all, you know what I mean, what he did, but it's ironic as fuck. Cause y'all gotta hear who he killed. And it looks like he did it. And not alleged. He did the shit. You know what I mean? Let's see if we can find it real quick. So check this out, y'all.
A rapper from Panola County is behind bars charged with murder. WRG's Mike Sirianni spoke with the victim's grandmother who witnessed that shooting.
He was a real soft-hearted person. He did it whatever he could to help anybody. He was a really nice person.
Mary Ann Strong is the grandmother of 40-year-old Marcus Wheatley, gunned down Wednesday behind his mobile home where he was a barber. Strong says she saw Kadarius Pride.
The nigga killed his barber. He killed his barber, y'all. Not funny, but ironic like a motherfucker. And I hope the jokes don't start about that. You know what I mean? But it's a little deeper than that. But this nigga's out of here now. And he's from Mississippi. So, yeah, let's go back to the story. This is crazy.
Behind his mobile home where he was a barber. Strong says she saw Kadarius Pride, a.k.a. Superstar Pride, the man charged with Wheatley's death, enter the mobile home, heard loud voices, and saw an armed Pride chase her grandson out
crazy.
Of the mobile home.
And the young man was following him, shooting at him, and he finally shot him down.
Strong ran to this field, and she watched in horror as Pride continued to fire at her grandson.
He fell here. He shot about three times.
Your son is a maniac.
After he fell, and he walked over to me, and he pointed the gun at me and asked me if I was going to tell it.
She says she had no idea what Pride meant, but she says he wasn't finished.
And he Look. Came back out here and fired a last shot in his head.
She wow. says Pride left in his red pickup truck, later found abandoned in Pope, Mississippi. He later turned himself in to the Panola County Sheriff's Office. Pride's father could offer no reason for what his son allegedly did.
You know, it's still just something that's got to be looked into and to see what, you know, what all transpired. You know, as of now, it's just so early.
But Marianne Strong believes the shooting resulted from Wheatley's refusal to take part in one of Pride's music videos in California.
He wanted Marcus to follow him, and Marcus couldn't do it.
Damn.
He couldn't help him make more money.
In Panola County, Mike Suriani, WREG News Channel 3.
Sad thing for a grandmother
to witness. In the meantime, Kadarius Pride is being held without bond.
Sad state of affairs. But yeah, it looked like he did that shit. Got a witness who, you know what I mean? But you could look at him, like, I look at certain people and be like, yeah, he got a murderous rage in his face. I wish I could find a video where I said that. Like, yo, this dude look like he did a couple of things, you know what I mean? One of them crazy light-skinned dudes. And to walk around with your hair like that, bro, sad, man. Sad he took that dude out. But I thought it was ironic that the dude was a barber, you know what I mean? That's nuts. That's nuts that he did that. Anyway, that's a somber news. Let's get into some other shit, man. Okay, where's this one at? Somebody sent me this. I don't have the link, but maybe we can copy and paste it and let's see what this is. Cause I said somebody's bugging. So let's see what this is, guys. Let's pull it up. And let's put it in the handy-dandy search bar. See what we come up with. What is this? Okay, the video. Oh, they must have took the video down. Okay, good. All right, guess it wasn't that important. All right, next subject on the docket. My bad, y'all. My bad, that wasn't nothing. All right, so this is something I didn't know about. Now, Inspector Deck from the Wu-Tang, shout out to him. Is arguably one of the most underrated rappers of all time. I need to do that list again of the most underrated rappers of all time because Inspector Deck is on there. Because if you listen to Triumph, Protect Your Neck, anytime Inspector Deck verse start, you already know it's going to be the craziest verse on each song. That's why they put him in front. Back in the days, it was a song called, it was Tupac and Method Man. I don't know if y'all remember this song. I think it was called My Mind Made Up. It was Tupac, Method Man, and a couple other people in the song. Got My Mind Made Up. I think it was this song right here, y'all.
I heard you saying that she was get through him last week. Run control, not possible. What a fast key.
Whoa. I don't know what was that. This song right here.
These motherfuckers are bored. We need verbal support. And when I command the microphone, I get delicate condo. With a bear and a snake and a panda.
Okay, what's this song, y'all?
Who can't withstand the more power gang?
This is on the legendary All Eyes on Me album. This song right here. Now, I don't know if y'all ever heard the original version of this song. Inspector Deck is on this song. And Tupac hated on him. That's news for me. Inspector Deck was originally on this song. Somehow, the song never got released. Pac got his hands on the song, listened to it, took Inspector Deck's verse off. And I believe that Corrupt confirmed that Pac was hating on him. Let's see. I think I have the video. Go back in. Hold on, guys. My bad. Let's go back to this. Got eight videos playing the same time. My bad. Let's start it over again.
That was actually for the Dog Pound album. I went and picked up Redman and Meth and Inspector Deck from the hotel. Rage was already at Daz's house. And then I rolled them on over to Daz's house. And we were making that for the Dog Pound album. The original person on it was Rage. Mm. And then, of course, Daz, with his lazy self, he loses the files.
Mm.
And we making dog food. I'm like, we got to get this record. Man, Rage already put a rap on one of her records. We don't need that record. We didn't do that. As soon as Pac gets home, he finds it.
Mm.
I said, you dirty dog, you lazy, dirty dog. And we give it to Pac. Inspector Deck is on the original one.
At the end, it says, INS the Rebel, and then cuts off.
Sure does.
Yeah. Turn my states to pebble. Mental terrorist specialists at this. Menacing lyricist leaves crews defenseless.
Why y'all cut him off the record?
Oh, man, Tupac was on fire.
I get it. I understand.
Beat is over. Okay? Just take him off.
Damn it.
Wait,
man.
But it sound tight, Pac. I mean, I don't want to hear all that tight stuff, man. Take that off. So Daz kind of threw a little slickness on him. Took him off, but he kept his background. Yeah. Sis, this. Dad was like, man, we're going to keep some of this stuff. Wow. He was tight, man. Give it up for the Inspector. You know what I'm saying? Pac didn't hear it until the record was out. Mm-mm. He ain't noticed none of that at the end. So he didn't care.
Mm-mm.
He was just being mean. You know?
So, yeah, y'all. Pac got Inspector Deck off the verse, man. And you know what I like about Deck? And shout out to you, Inspector Deck. I mean, he reposted one of my videos, first of all, recently, which is neither here nor there. He reposted one of my videos recently. It's one I made when I did the video doing the imitation of the Hulu RZA. Inspector Deck reposted that video, and I was honored that he did that. But I think we need to give him his flowers, man. That dude was a legend, man. And he the one Wu-Tang member that never really got his shot. And y'all know, I don't know if you guys know, it was a flood in the RZA's apartment back then. And he was next up to get his album, but that album got destroyed in the flood, all of those beats. And y'all know, if y'all know anything about the RZA, dude was a mad scientist with those beats. And to lose them all like that, this was back with floppy discs. This is before anything was digitally saved. You guys saved all your shit on the disc. For you kids out there, he lost all of it. And Inspector Deck is that one. I think that window, I mean, he eventually dropped the project, but that album that he was going to drop, it would have been up there with Liquid Swords. It would have been up there with the Purple Tape. You know what I mean? You know, Built for Cuban Links. Would have been up there with Takao probably. But yeah, Pac hated on him. For all you Pac stans out there. I didn't say fans. I said stans because I'm a fan. But some of y'all stans out there. You act like the man can't do no fucking wrong. He hated on Inspector Deck, y'all. It's documented. He hated on him. They did a song together. Pac took his verse off. And I think it's because Deck bodied it. That's what I believe. You know what I mean? But anyway, moving along, y'all. Let's keep it on rappers for a minute. All right, so now, this is what I want to know, right? I'm not in no gang, and I'm not in the LGBTQ community. But I've heard gangs super denounce homosexual activity. It's a gay rapper out right now. I mean, there's gay rappers, right? But they're like Saucy Santana and shit. You know what I mean? Like, he's flaming. You know what I mean? But this is the first openly gay gangster rapper, y'all. He claiming Crip hard. And he been openly talking about it. And I caught a little clip from one of his interviews. And I need to know from my Crip homies, How y'all feel about this? Is this co-sign? I mean, he's. I mean, from what I know, it's a dangerous thing to scream that you in the gang and you ain't in it. So obviously, he in the gang for real, for real. Like, I need to know for my own personal, you know what I mean? But check this out, y'all. This is an interview on Boss Talk. Shout out to Boss Talk, one-on-one podcast. He had an interview with him, and his name is Tony Wilrich. Check this out, y'all.
That's a crip.
Yes, that's absolutely 100%, 1,000 correct.
Because we do have, is there an openly gay, there is an openly gay rapper, right?
Ain't? Yeah, but it's a bunch of them, and some of them not open, though. You know what I'm saying? But
that's a fact.
But it's definitely a bunch of them, but I'm just trying to understand
gangsta
the crip part. The crip part.
I'm a gangster rapper, so like, it's no openly gangster gay rappers out here. You got Saucy Santana, he ain't no gangster. You got Lil Nas, he ain't no gangster. I'm a gangster. So that's the difference between me and all these other rappers.
So what makes you a gangster?
Because I used to, I'm a crimp, and I grew up on the South Side.
But I'm trying. Did you get jumped in or sworn in? How did we know you were official?
Okay, so I grew up on the South Side, and I used to hang around with all these different crimps, and we became friends. So like they was crimps or shit. You know, I was in a little clique, you know, and shit. I was like, well, shit, I'm a crimp too.
Nah, that's not how it worked. That's not. He not official. He not official. He not official. Nah, he ain't official. Yo, we need to look up more information. He ain't official. I want to hear. Nah, he ain't official. He ain't sanctioned. And I'm not even a gang member. I'm saying he not official. Like, I didn't know you could just get in like that from hanging around people. You know what I mean? Unless, the only way I can see him like being official and other members co-signing him is if they, you know what I mean? As if they got topped off or something like that. And they gotta kind of go along with it or he gonna expose them. You know what I'm saying? Let me see. If there's any like other Crips reaction. Let's see. From a Crip. What? Gay Crip Tony Rich and Percy OG link up. Oh, well, shit. If I'm not mistaken, OG Percy speaks on openly gay Crip rapper Tony Rich. Okay. Because OG Percy is a Crip and he's certified, I believe. Let's check out, see what he had to say about it.
Hey, real, this is interesting, y'all.
You are now tuned
interesting
to the Bob Report.
Interesting.
Go, Crips! That's what we do, nigga. A lot of Crip love, nigga. I love to see when Crips come together and show. See, look, y'all, when you throw the C by yourself, nigga, it's just you. But when you throw another C with a C and you put it together in the middle, what you got? You got a heart. That's love, nigga. Y'all feel me? Y'all gotta teach you young niggas every goddamn thing.
Interesting.
I say you got a heart, nigga, in the middle of that. Yeah, when you throw the seeds like this and you connect them, what that mean? You got, I did that with my boy, Maxo Cream. When me and Maxo Cream locked
in, man, I ain't about to listen to all this shit, man.
When they get to Houston, they lock it up and they make it a C. But at the end, Maxo Cream, I told Maxo, I said, he said, hit it up, because a lot of niggas from Fort Worth can't go.
Let me see.
And in Houston, when you go lock down there, and they ain't never been to Houston.
Think about old Tony, man.
Tony his own self person, you know what I'm saying? See, one thing, that nigga taking pictures with me. Say, I ain't got no complex. I'm a man. I don't know what you niggas is. I'm saying, see, when you got a man that's still on the side of something that ain't a man, or whatever you want to call it, a woman, you understand me? A woman, you know, that's their priority. You understand? That's their priority. I learned that from Bobby Brown way back in the day, nigga. It's my priority to be who I want to be. Be you. I have a choice. I know one thing about it. If I see somebody that ain't on my openly level, you know, ways of acting, that's not my business. I remember back in the day, they say they used to jump on them. But I used to protect, you know, the other side, you know, the funny bunnies. They couldn't help themselves. I never like seeing nobody jump on nobody, bro.
Yeah.
They couldn't fight back. I don't give a damn with a man.
Nah, see, I get all that, bro. I get all that. And I would too. I would, if somebody was bullying somebody for being gay, I would, but as a Crip member, I'm asking as a citizen, and other people want to know, do Crips co-sign homosexuality? That's a valid question, bro. So fuck being cool with a gay guy. I got plenty of gay homeboys. Plenty of gay friends. You know what I mean? But also, I'm not no gang member. Never have been. But do Crips openly co-sign a gay Crip member? You know what I'm saying? Because if you a rapper and you rep a certain area and you rep a certain set, you know, you guys kind of all link up. So is that something that's being held up? You know? I just want to know.
You know what I'm saying? Whatever the fuck you going, they go for any nigga. I've never been the type of person that target the weak. You dig what I'm saying? I feel like any man that target
going in circles.
The weak, there's something weak about him.
Yeah.
Gotta be. Because guess what? Any man that targets the weak, wait till somebody get at them. Wait till somebody get at them.
Bro, ask him the right question, nigga. Damn. This nigga ain't even answering the question, bro.
But yeah, shout out to Tony Reary, man. Shout out for the pictures, man. I'm seeing a lot of things. I don't believe in the pain. I don't believe in gangsters flipping to be around the other side. See, when them niggas start flipping y'all, that's what y'all was from the jump.
Okay.
We start putting your fingernails and toes and lipsticks and eyebrows, and next thing that you walk on this motherfucker, you got it. Nigga, it's them. Eyelashes, nigga. Oh, yeah, cool. I just got the old put on, cool.
Okay, now the interviewer is supposed to ask him that question.
Go ahead, Bob. Make it make sense.
Make it make sense, Percy.
Shit, I'm asking you to.
Well, I can't make that one.
Appreciate you. I can't either. By the time me and Bob agree on something today. Shit, nigga. I can't make it make sense. He can't either. Yeah.
See, that's not what I'm talking about, bro. Like, he's co-signing. He's saying he's a gangster. We know the gay part, but he's claiming your gang, bro. But you just said that they can't. These niggas is weirdos. This is why I don't fuck with gang shit. Respectfully, like, I don't. This is why I can't fuck with this shit. Like, I mean, that ain't why I couldn't fuck with it. I always thought, personally, it was corny to have any representation of men and be a part of a group like that. You know what I mean? It had rules and shit. Like, I always went against that type of shit. Anything like that. You know what I mean? I just never co-signed none of that shit. Never had to do it. And also, I'm from New York. You know what I'm saying? And I tell people this all the time. Like, I know a lot of real-ass dudes who turned blood, right? But a lot of them became big homies. A lot of them was Decepticons. Or they came home from jail. And they was the leaders of the shit. But it was a lot of pussy niggas, man. And Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn, East New York, Brownsville too, back when I was younger. I'm not talking about now. I'm talking about the young, when I was niggas my age who was churning blood. It's because they was pussy. Because they was pussy. And they needed that gang representation, because Brooklyn and New York and as a whole, black guys was never on that. Gangs was more like a Puerto Rican thing. I mean, you had like little neighborhood shit like the Decepticons, and it wasn't really gang ridden. Like New York, if it was a New York gang, it was original Brooklyn shit or original Queens shit, like LB Fam. I was just talking about that earlier. If you remember the Lost Boys, I lived in Queens for a little while. Shout out to my niggas Cedric and all of them out there from Queens, Southside Queens, Jamaica Queens. LB Fam wasn't just the Lost Boys. Mr. Cheeks, Big Nikes, Pretty Lou, and Freaky Ty, rest in peace. It wasn't just them. Yo, LB Fam, it was hundreds, maybe thousands of them. They was just a part of a collective. It was mad at them. They was just the rappers. But LB Fam, they all had the LB Fam tattoo on their forearm. It was mad at them. That was some queen shit. It was a lot of them niggas. You know what I mean? And that's all original New York shit. But when the Bloods and Crips came, and I started seeing these pussy niggas who never fought nobody, never did nothing. They were scared to fight people. We all fought growing up. I mean, niggas wasn't no shooters. We fought. We fought. We got jumped people. It always was the hands. Granted, every now and then you heard about a nigga getting shot, but for the most part, we was outside fighting as teenagers. You know what I'm saying? And then when the gang shit came, it kind of fucked everything up because it was like, damn, like, this some L.A. shit. That shit was corny. It was corny when it first came. Now it grew into a life of its own. But when it first came to Brooklyn, most niggas I know was not jacking that shit at all. Because that was some L.A. shit. The pussy niggas was on it. And the dudes that just came from jail was on it because they had it in jail already. And the dudes who really was tough, who wanted to have their own sets, they was a part of it. You know what I mean? And maybe the niggas that was really close to them. But a handful of them was real dudes. The rest of them was pussy. Straight up. Straight up. Anybody got a problem with what I said? Holla. Y'all know what I'm talking about. A lot of you niggas that was turning blood in the late 90s was pussy in New York. That's a fact. I'm not talking about you new dudes that grew up with it. I'm talking about when it first came to New York to Brooklyn. I'm not talking about the Bronx. BX was out in the BX already. But Queens and Brooklyn niggas who was turning blood in the late 90s, that was like 16, 17, you niggas was pussy. Because that was not some New York shit. Unless you went to jail or unless you was a big homie immediately and starting your own set, or close with one of the big homies, you random dudes who was getting ran out of the hood or wasn't doing nothing, y'all was pussy niggas. Straight up. For real. Anyway, I don't even like talking about that shit because that ain't even my cup of tea. But whatever. Moving along. Oh, where's the docket at? Is it gone? Oh, come on. Guys. Oh, here we go. All right, so this was wild to me, y'all. I want y'all to hear what this chick said. I want y'all to hear what this chick had to say. And then we're going to get into some other shit. This is what I was talking about with accountability with women. And it's a dude here kind of co-signing what she's saying. I want y'all to hear what this chick is talking about here. This is crazy.
Pet peeve. Gentlemen, please don't do this to bitches. Ugh. Just keep trying to stop putting soft, semi
that's the gummy.
Soft
hold on.
Dicks in women.
Come on, yeah, that's the
public service announcement. Stop putting semi-soft dicks in women. We don't want it. We don't want to feel it grow.
Like,
First of all, shorty, why is his dick soft going in you? Why? If his meat, now granted, some dudes got ED out there. But if he's a fully functional male, he ain't got no problems out there. If he putting the soft meat in you, you didn't arouse him. Because if you gave him head before or you played with it before, it should be on rock. I've had women top me off and get mad at me. Because you're not getting hard? No, you trash. You're doing a bad job. And these dudes sitting here like, oh, the gummy, what were you? Why was I'm baffled as to why that wasn't his question. Why is he soft? This chick put out a PSA about don't put soft dick in women. How about you make it hard? That's your job. But see, the thing is, a lot of women think their presence is enough. Oh, I'm here. You should just be ready. Nah. No, some of us need a kickstart too. A lot of women shit just ain't wet. You got to eat it a little bit, kiss on her. Play with it a little bit. She ain't just gonna be ready. Y'all be wanting niggas to be on go and you ain't do nothing. For her to make that statement speaks volumes, yo. Volumes. Hear this shit again, man.
Pet peeve. gentlemen, please don't do this to bitches. Just keep trying to put a stop putting soft, semi
that's the gummy.
Soft
hold on.
Dicks in women.
Come on, yeah, that's the
public service announcement. Stop putting semi soft dicks in women. We don't want it. We don't want to feel it grow.
Like,
Wait a minute.
If I put the half in and that it grow up in it grow up in there,
okay,
we gotta
okay,
go.
Okay.
Do I feel like I'm doing something?
Like in the morning?
I do.
But don't, I do. I like don't do get soft and think that we don't notice.
Wait, don't
we
get soft
notice.
And keep trying to put your soft, flaccid dick in my and it's not that. Staying.
Well, that's when you gotta go to the bathroom and talk to your dick. You
yes,
gotta,
do whatever needs to be
bro,
done.
Like, get the what
and
you
don't
doing?
Don't expect me to suck it over and over again for your problems.
Yeah, no. That's see. That is what you're supposed to do, though. Yo, that's crazy. Women be so quick to blame men on their shortcomings when it's their responsibility. Because I swear to God, if a chick is not getting wet, sometimes that's on her. She probably smoked too much weed. She probably got an IUD. Yeah, I know about these things. Chicks smoke a lot of weed. A lot of times your pussy dry out. Dead ass. Ladies, if you smoke too much marijuana, your pussy gonna be dry. That's a fact. You're gonna need a spit start or some shit like that. If you got an IUD or your period about to drop, you might be dry. I know all of these things. I've been on this earth long enough to understand how the coochie work. You know what I mean? But some of you chicks, your pH is off. You just don't get wet. But some of y'all are simply just not aroused. You know what I mean? And if you ain't aroused, it's the man's job to arouse you, to make sure you're comfortable. Because y'all got lube. Y'all got shit y'all can just put on there and be good. Sometimes we need you. We need that mouth. We need that hand. We need you to do something. Don't put a soft dick in me. Well, shorty, take care of your business then. Take care of your business, because shorty, who I was with last week, I'm always rock. I'm always rock. But with you, you don't want to put in that work and then blame it on me. Come on, man. Give me a break, shorty. That's a nasty thing to say. And to not consider that some of that is maybe your problem, maybe your fault. Come on, man. And these niggas sitting there laughing, oh, you don't like the gummy? The niggas probably got ED. That's corny as shit. That's corny. You know what I mean? Wow. Where we at? How much time we got left? Oh, yeah. I wanted to get into this, y'all. Speaking of ladies, let's stay on this. I got to get that video out of my phone, guys. Jess Hilarious is under fire right now. Hello, I'm not on the phone. Jess Hilarious is under fire right now, y'all, for some comments she made. Matter of fact, let's look for it. Because she said a couple of things about the trans community. And I want you guys to hear it in case you didn't. And then I want to talk to you guys about how this should be handled. What is this? Okay, here we go.
It's gonna stand up for us.
Okay, let me see if I can. You know, I'm just gonna play it on here.
See if we can.
Oh, here it goes.
It's gonna stand up for us. Who the fuck stands up for us? And us, I mean women, real women, biological women, women who were born with all the parts that you guys wish that you were. When does the delusion stop? What is the difference between you and someone who has been diagnosed to be mentally insane? What's the only difference is you don't have a straitjacket on. Stop talking out your fucking ass. Wake up. How are you projecting your anger on real women? Because we are the gatekeepers. We are the gatekeepers for periods. We the only one that fucking bleed, honey. We the only ones that can give birth. We make y'all people. We make y'all. Y'all come from us. You can't be us. You will never. You're chasing something you'll never, ever get. You'll never be that. Fuck is going to stand up for us.
Okay. All right. She went there, y'all. Now, if a man said that, y'all already know what time it is. Out of here. Now, we do know the biggest supporters of the LGBTQ community are women. That's a fact. Women are the biggest supporters. Now you got a woman who's speaking out against the trans community due to all of these things that's happening. And I'm watching. And I'm keeping my motherfucking mouth shut. Because I find it to be ironic that the people who are in the future, you know, the way it's looking, that's going to have to deal with the bulk of this are biological women. Because a trans man, which is a woman who makes the transition to a man, they can't, you can't, they can't replace men. You know, the science doesn't exist to turn a vagina into a dick that has feeling. But you can convert a penis into a vagina. They've done it. I've watched YouTube videos and saw the surgery. They're coming up with technology to where one day they'll be able to put a uterus inside of a trans woman to produce a baby, and the baby can grow, and he gives birth. She gives birth. They're calling your pussy a bonus hole. They're claiming to have periods now, telling you women you don't own periods. Let me see if I can find that video. It's getting out of hand. Women, I saw that video. Women don't own periods. A trans woman said that. Maybe the video is here. Hopefully it is. Oh yeah, this is it. This is it right here. Check this out, y'all. This is a trans woman saying this. Check this out.
This is what I mean when the transphobia just comes out. The audacity and just the arrogance for cis women to believe that they own periods, that they own womanhood.
That is insane to say that. Like the audacity. Like you are literally transitioning to be one of them. And you're talking like this. Why can't women say that? That's dangerous, yo. Like, can trans people be canceled for doing this? How is it transphobic to say, hey, I'm a woman, I own womanhood? How is that transphobic for a woman to say that? That is insane to me, yo. That is insane to me.
Don't. Okay, you don't own periods, you don't own womanhood. You experience both, and both are different for every person, but as a cis woman, it doesn't belong to you. So-
Y'all, we...
Wow. Wow. Let me see what she had to say about this.
We don't even have periods no more, bro. How dare we? How dare we as biological women think that we own the rights to menstruation? How dare we, with our ovaries and uterus and fallopian tubes, think that we claim ownership to the experience of menstruating, y'all?
The fact that they're able to even have them now, the fact that it's a literal fight for trans women to be included in sports, that shit is unfair. Because think about it. If a trans man is not going to work the same. A trans man, a woman who wants to convert into a man, she wants to get into football. He wants to get into football or basketball or you know what I mean, or boxing. No, you're not. I don't give a fuck what how much hormones you take. You're not competing with the best male athletes. You'll be with the trash male athletes. You probably could beat some of them. But you're not beating the average man. It's not happening. You know, statistics show the worst that Leah, I forgot the name, the one who was a swimmer, was ranked like number 430 with men's swimming and then transitioned and was the number one woman swimmer. That's just how far off it is when it comes to athletic abilities with men and women. That's not an insult to women. That's just saying men are, we're bigger and we're stronger, we're faster. That's just the way it is. Now, back to Jess Hilarious. It's both sides of the field in this because one, what she said would be considered transphobic and hate speech, right? Do you cancel her for that? Because she doesn't get canceled. It shows the direct inequalities with men and women. Because if a man says some shit like that, it's a rap for him. You know what I mean? But also, I say biological women should stand behind her. That's not fair. Imagine trans men saying that some shit like that to men. Even the men who claim to support it. These Republicans, they're past fucking laws. You kidding me? These fucking conservative and liberal white men. But because it's physically impossible for a woman to be ever. Like a woman could never have a dick and come out of it and make a baby if she transitioned. But they're creating science to where trans women can have periods and eventually have babies on their own without a woman. So they're trying to find an alternative to women. As a matter of fact, the fact that you're even called a cis woman, not just a woman, a cis woman, that's crazy. You have to have a term, a prefix, a pronoun put in front of your title of your gender, because other people who are not you, they weren't born as you, they need to be specified. They're a guest of what they're not an imitation. I don't want to say imitation because that sounds so insulting. They're of a different gender that's trying to transition into you. They're not you. They, like she said, they will never be. They can't be. They can look like it all they want, but the parts are not going to be the same. But they, it's some that can look exactly like a woman. And I've never seen a, but I did see the little, the penis vagina that was created. You know, I've never seen it like in action or one fully healed. I saw it during the surgery, but you know what I'm saying? To the untrained eye, some of them look just like women. And it's very interesting to see what happened in the future. But I think women should rally behind Jess Hilarious. I think her delivery was a little fucked up. You know what I mean? I think she was speaking out of anger. She probably was speaking to the comment section or speaking to that last video, because that video I just played with Shorty talking was fucking offensive as shit. If I was a woman, that would be very offensive to me. And that probably triggered her to say it, you know? But I get a message. She articulated way wrong. Because of her position in the industry, she shouldn't have did that. But some of us don't give a fuck. I don't. So salute to her. I mean, she's standing up for what she believes in. She's speaking on what she believes in, and I respect it. I respect her doing that. You know, if you don't stand for nothing, you'll fall for anything. Also, the first person to break the ceiling is the first person to get cut. So maybe she did start something. We'll see. It's been really quiet, though. But I know if this was the shoes on the other foot, man, this shit would have been a big deal. That shit got swept under the rug. All right, so let's get to what I want to talk about today. I've been having a lot of banter, a lot of back and forth with dudes from the South, right? So I'm going to throw y'all a bone today, because I've always, I didn't think this when I was going through it, but I think it now as an adult. New York has a very embarrassing period in rap. We should be ashamed of it. And it didn't age well. And I think about it now, I call it the cartoon era. It was a wacky, wild time in the early 90s. You know what I mean? It was like, had to be between like 91 and 95. It was this era where niggas wasn't rapping. They would just put any words together. They did these wacky voices and sound effects. And I'm gonna give you an example of this shit. This shit was trash. This shit was garbage. It was nasty work. Like, it was the worst shit ever. These niggas wasn't talking about nothing. It was a group called the Fooshnickens. the Foosh niggas. When I say this nigga was Who Framed Roger Rabbit? Oh my God. Hold on. Foosh niggas. Y'all gotta hear this shit. Oh my God. This is one of the worst songs I've ever heard in my life. It's terrible. And when I was a kid, once again, I loved this shit. I thought this shit was the best shit I ever heard in my life. Yo, listen to this shit.
Break down. The flow. We shot the dramatic. I ain't come raid your town with the sound.
All right, he's coming, y'all. Okay. Y'all need y'all to sit down and buckle your seats for this because you about to hear some really wacky animaniacs. That's all folks. Chip Foo, if you out there, bro, what's good with you, my nigga? What were you talking about, bro?
I can't see a thing like Mr. Magoo this living thing. Stuffy naughty. Happy check in the box. Dreadlock Fox on there. What's up? Tick-tock. Oops. Shiver me to my boots. Oh my gosh. Oh my goose sucks.
Yo, is this Who Framed Roger Rabbit, bro? This nigga just making mad sound effects. Wacky. Out of this world, son. This shit is garbage, bro. No replay value. New York, we need to be ashamed of ourselves for this era. We had a cartoon bar era. It was fun. But I remember they played all this shit at my junior high school, elementary school prom, all the block parties. This shit was for children, bro. These niggas ain't talking about nothing.
Now I got the hiccups and I rips up many tracks. Jump in your hoes and facts. Don't make a sound. I see little rabbit twacks like thunder and lightning. Must have frightening. Can't you tell them?
Oh my fucking God, bro. This is terrible.
Ooh, they don't know me very well, so I lump some pills them with black eyes and stitches. The mag could be rent from rags and the riches. Now my scruples, I lose them. Damn it, I grew some. I'm too face that still call me for goose from poof from. I got secrets, but I don't know, like Yoko. I'm home, I'm changing visions, blurry, so call me. I'm Quasimoto. Yo, I'll switch up, switch up, switch up, switch up, switch up. Without the hiccups, that's MCs quickly pick up. Then I freaks my fool sticks out on the microphone, yo, creep it. And I freaks it, freaks it, freaks it. When I speaks it with my drunken tongue, I make your pips, but now it's back to the lagoon. Way up since quick and don't sleep when it's time.
He had to be imitating Who Framed Roger Rabbit because he's doing all the sound effects in the movie. So I'm gonna end it off on this last cartoon song, right? Back in the days, Big Daddy Kane had it. Oh my god. All right, soon, if you guys follow me on Instagram at Wil Milz or on TikTok or on Facebook, you guys know I do top five trash lists. So I'm gonna give you guys a little prequel to one of my lists that I'm about to do. This list is the worst hip-hop voices of all time. And this guy is going on that list. When I say this man's voice, there's no way he really talked like this. You know what I mean? He didn't talk like this. He definitely was doing that. It was a song. Now, look, check this out. This song had the potential to be one of the biggest collabs ever. Let me tell you everybody who was in the song. It was Big Daddy Kane, Sauce Money, Shaheem the Rugged Child, Jay-Z, a young Jay-Z, and Old Dirty Bastard. That collab is crazy. But Big Daddy Kane dropped one of the worst verses I've ever heard in my life. ODB was all right. Jay-Z was trash. Sauce Money was trash. I mean, I guess it was okay for its time. This was 1994. The only one who had a good verse on here was Shaheem. Scoob was first. And I believe that Scoob that's on here is Big Daddy Kane's dancer. Because Big Daddy Kane was known to have dances. This was back in the days in Brooklyn where we danced, right? And the rappers had dances. Heavy D had dances. Big Daddy Kane was one of the showmen. You know, a lot of people say Jay-Z got a swag from him. Big Daddy Kane was the first swag rapper. He was good looking. The women loved him. He was fly. He was on his sexy shit. The nigga was on Playboy back in the day. No, Playgirl. Meet Out. He did porn, I think, some shit. Big Daddy Kane was on some next shit. Anyway, Scoop and Scrap Lover was his dancers. And I believe that Scoop, that's on this song, it's Scoob that was one of his dancers. This verse I'm about to play, this voice, guys, hold on to your ears or click off, because you're about to hear the most annoying shit you ever heard in your life. Let's get it. Oh, my God.
Hey, laugh now, nigga. My man's right behind you. Can't pull the trigger. I don't play. I'm from the hill where shit is real. And I'll be on your ass like bugs on the windshield.
And I'll be on your ass like bugs on the windshield. First of all, the nigga's fit is crazy. He got some kind of one-piece denim janitor shit on. Open. It's huge. His... We gotta start that over, y'all. Ha ha! Hang, hang my hands on that chica. This shit is whack.
Ha ha! Hey, hey, laugh now, nigga. My man's right behind you. Can't pull the trigger. I don't play. I'm from the hill where shit is real, and I be on your ass like
bugs on the windshield.
I cut hand, you still can't get no pause. You could end it with school if we was playing cards. But if I got beef, then it-
wow, wow, guys, wow. You couldn't dab a scuba if you was playing cards. That's one thing niggas can do. They, when they couldn't really find words, they would stretch out a one-syllable word to its limits. You know what I mean?
I'm for cold red. My gun is like a hoe. It be taking mad niggas to bed. So
pause. Yo. Yo. For those who aren't watching, that whole part was wild. Because as he said that, this is funny. This is... this. Oh, wow. Okay. Okay. The DJ in this video is Mr. C, right? So Mr. C, who we know is a Brooklyn DJ, was Biggie's DJ, who over the years got caught with a couple of trannies. And he fully admitted it. He liked taking a dick or two every once in a blue. He came out the closet with it. As he said, my gun is like a, some shit, be, my gun is like a, what he said? Well, my gun is like a something to be taking my niggas to bed. He said that. As he said to be taking my niggas to bed, the camera switched over to Mr. C, and he smiled into the camera. This song predicted the future, or they already knew what was time where it was with this nigga. That was very interesting, guys.
He was playing cards, but if I got beef, then it's time for cold red. My gun is like a hoe, it be taking mad niggas to bed.
Yeah. Wow, wow. Wow. It said, my gun is like a hoe, be taking mad niggas to bed. And Mr. C was like this, shaking his head, yeah. Wow. 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 Okay. Let's keep going.
So hurry up and skedaddle. Even if you join the army, you still couldn't battle. So where you from? England? You somebody great? You burning school? I don't think so, mate.
Yo. Yo. But you're from England. Get that right. I don't think so, mate. Oh, wait, fuck. Hold on. First of all, horrible English accent. And did he say good night, mate? Did he do an Australian accent? Wow, that was nasty, y'all.
Battle. Even if you join the army, you still couldn't battle. So where you from? England? You somebody great? You burning school? I don't think so, mate. Yo, sauce if you're down with the crew. Get on the mic and won't you show and prove?
Hey. That era, that era, that era, man. Oh, my God. I can't believe that existed, New York. So, South, you guys got a reference point. Just like I told y'all, back in the 90s, y'all niggas was out there. You know what I mean? Y'all know when this came on. Y'all know what y'all was doing, bro. We don't got to act crazy like y'all don't know what was going on. You niggas was out there shaking ass and dick. Y'all know what y'all was doing this game on. Y'all was shaking ass. The niggas was. The niggas was. The niggas was. Not the girls. The niggas. Gyrating. Y'all know what y'all was doing this game on. And here's proof. Look who this is. Look. Trick Daddy on this shit too. I made fun of these niggas too much over this shit. I put up videos. I showed them what they was doing. They still mad. They denying it. But we know you niggas was shaking ass and dick in the 90s. All right? Y'all was shaking ass and dick in the early 90s. The South was shaking ass and dick in the 90s. And we was rapping like cartoon characters. Okay? I say we even, bro. That's equally nasty work. I would even argue that even though y'all was shaking ass and dick, the women liked it. The women liked all that dick popping shit, right? Every now and then you would turn around and shake your ass too. Pause. The women was into it. You know what I mean? That's why they had those type of backup dancers. But we had a cartoon era in rap that I don't think women was into. I think children liked it and backpack niggas liked it. That's why it got out of here real fast. You know, soon in came the backpack rap, which was street gritty. When your Mobb Deep came, your Black Moons, Helter Skelters. And then soon the Wu-Tang was with that. And then soon came in Nas and then Jay-Z and Biggie, and they brought it to bars. That's when the bars came in. You know what I mean? When it came to the bars, you know, you had to be good. And that they got these niggas out of here. They packed that cartoon shit up so fast, out of New York, out of the rap game, and thank God. We didn't even know how bad that cartoon shit was until we heard niggas like Nas and Wu-Tang and all that. You know what I mean? And I'm glad it ended. And I'm glad it never made a comeback. You know what I'm saying? But it's still nostalgic to hear like Daz Effects in the club or something like that. I actually met them. They was out here not too long ago. No, they was out here like 2 years ago. I actually met them with K-Solo, and then I met K-Solo's son, and I'm cool with his son now. Daz Effects, you know, they older now. Nick still ain't got no mustache. They're crazy, you know what I mean? But anyway, y'all, don't forget, man, August 26th, I will be doing the What the Fuck comedy tour starring Joe Torre. If y'all don't know who that is, Joe Torre, that's Chicago from Def Jam. I mean, Chicago from Poetic Justice. I remember him from Def Jam back in the days. His brother Guy Torre is a touring comedian as well. That should be a pretty dope show. That's going to be a dream city out here in Orlando, Florida. Tickets are on sale now. You know what I mean? So make sure you get those tickets and pull up to that show. That's going to be a big show. I'm on it. Shout out to my brother Kevin Dean and my boy Nuke is going to be hosting that show. It's going to be a big, fun show for that. You know what I mean? But anyway, y'all, that's going to be episode 186 in the books. Give it up to my boy Fredo Cash. You know what I'm saying? Straight out of Baltimore for the All Jokes Aside song every week. Every week, you know, we got to play the song to send the show off. So till next time, I'll guys see you guys same time, same place. Let's get it. Amen. Fredo. I love it. I love it. Woo.
Me and Pyrex together, watch two words collide. Me and Jackie Boyd out the sweet room, got hella holes inside. Woo. I'm the shit. Bitch, all jokes aside. I'm the shit. Bitch, all jokes aside. Till next time, guys. I will see you next week. Same time, same blood clot place. Peace.